Your Steve Jones Show podcast is loading now. The Steve Jones Show podcast is sponsored by Purdy Insurance. Visit Purdy Insurance on Market Street in Sunbury or visit online at purdyinsurance.com. Sports talk where your voice counts. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now from the Sunbury Motor Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Today's show brought to you by Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. Purdy's have served the Valley for decades, finding their customers, right insurance, auto, home, life, business, whatever it may be, bundles, and finding the best price whenever possible, and making sure you're covered, updating policies, and if there's ever a claim, to go to work as if it happened to them. Customer service means everything to them because they are just great people. I mean, just great people. Outside of the office, they are great people. And it turns out they're great professionals. Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. And I'm in the Sunbury Motors studio. Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, Routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. Quick notes for you. First of all, Penn State ranked 13th in both the AP and in the coaches' polls. At Purdue tomorrow night at 6:30. We'll pick up the game in progress after Shikellamie Wrestling tomorrow. Lamar Stevens, the Lute Olson National Player of the Week. He is also the Big Ten Player of the Week. Adam Rittenberg from ESPN reporting that Brent Pry telling Michigan State no, staying at Penn State. Luke Fickle of Cincinnati has said no. Matt Campbell of Iowa State has said no. Pat Narduzzi of Pitt has said no. And who's the other one here? One more. Fickle, Campbell, and there's one more that said no. I'm not exactly rolling here with this job. They've all said no. And then the latest one came in is the janitor said no. No, I don't want this job. I didn't think that was good. But just a thought. So who are the leading candidates? Possibly Justin Wilcox of Cal, possibly Jim McElwain, the head coach at Central Michigan, possibly Brett Bielema, the outside linebackers coach for the New York Giants. But that is what has happened there with that job. All right. Time now for the play-by-play call of the day.
Jones a chance to give Duke the lead. On the way. No. Long rebound tapped out, controlled by Goldwire. Jones with three, with two for the win. No. Tapped up by Moore. And in at the buzzer. Moore banks it in. And the Blue Devils win it. 98-96. Trey Jones and Mike Krzyzewski embrace, and it's a Duke Blue kind of night in Chapel Hill.
Boy, was that... I'm watching that game Saturday night. That game was surreal. How the game went into overtime with Jones deliberately missing the free throw. He deliberately threw it up there in such a way to get a long rebound, which he then caught and then hit a three. It was surreal. What's interesting is if North Carolina, which is that North Carolina's what, 11 and 14? If North Carolina had won, they would have been 12 and 13. And I think the committee would have made them the number five seed. No, I'm just kidding. Just kidding. Yeah. So I want to get into something I think that's interesting that I thought College Game Day did a great job of bringing this up, and this deals with both football and men's basketball. And that happens to be the number of young men leaving early to go to the NFL or the NBA draft as underclassmen. Okay. And you always wish them well along the way. You want them to do well. You're rooting for them. And what happens is college the NCAA universities act as if they have no power in this, which is interesting. Because right now, they're acting as if they don't have any power. The NFL and the NBA set their respective rules, and then you have to follow the rules. Right? So the rule is in the NFL, you must be removed from high school 3 years. So you could be a true junior, you could be a redshirt sophomore. But you must be removed from high school for 3 years, and then you can put your name into the NFL draft. For the NBA, you must be 1 year removed from high school and must be 19 years of age before the next season begins. So two qualifiers. And most people, when they talk about this, don't talk about the 19 part. So those are the rules. And as you know, there have been a lot of student athletes that have left early, put their name into the NFL and NBA drafts, respectively. And there's also been large numbers that have gone undrafted. Usually in the NBA, it's somewhere from now, it could be as low as 60, as high as 100 of underclassmen that don't get picked. The NFL's trending more that same way. Large numbers not getting picked. And I'll give you two examples. Ryan Bates and Kevin Givens both put their names into the NFL draft a year ago and were not selected. Givens was with the 49ers, and Bates eventually went from the Eagles to the Buffalo Bills. On Saturday during College Game Day, I thought it was a very thoughtful discussion with Jay Billis, Alfonso Ellis, Seth Greenberg, and Reese Davis about what to do about this. And the NBA, college football and basketball, I think can seize this back by opening the door to letting these athletes come back. In other words, the NBA draft takes place right around June 20th to the 24th, somewhere in there. Matt follows it religiously. It's really interesting. Right up there with Disney. And I think that you should give, on the basketball side, June 30th to make up your mind as to whether or not you're coming back to school or not. In other words, I don't like where I got drafted. Okay, number one, I didn't get drafted. Okay. But number two, I don't like where they got drafted. It gives the student-athlete the power. I don't like where I got drafted. You know, I got drafted in the second round. I got picked by the Phoenix Suns. You know what? I think I can do better than that. I think they should open the door to let them back. So now you've got to think of all the worst-case scenarios. What does that now do to the numbers for a basketball team? Well, it's interesting how many grad transfers there are that happen late in the game. And again, what I do allows me to have a really good read on this. Because let's go back to what my preparation is. I do a lot of pre-prep in April and May. All right? But in college basketball, I usually have to go back in August and start going back through to see who transferred where. I'll give you an example that Penn State's playing tomorrow. Carson Edwards put his name early into the draft. Carson Edwards kept his name in the draft, and then eventually Carson Edwards was selected by the Celtics. Okay. Well, they had to fill that spot, so they filled it with High Point grad transfer Jihad Proctor, who didn't enter school until late August. So they had an opening under 13. They had the opening. And you'll find that most schools have the opening. Rozier Bolton transferred from Penn State to Iowa State. Penn State had the opening. They filled it with Curtis Jones. The opening was there. So Edwards went to the draft, was drafted, spot. Proctor comes in mid to late summer and joins Purdue as a grad transfer. So they obviously had the opening. So say, for example, Edwards wasn't enamored with the fact that he got picked by the Celtics and the position he was picked. And so just say he feels that way. He should have had the option to come back if he wanted to. And it forces the NBA's hand in some ways. Same thing with the NFL, except you put in a different standard, April 30th. Penn State at the moment, I think most people know, is a little bit over the 85 limit. That's if, you know, this, when I mean over, they're not currently over the second. But if all the recruits come in and nothing in the roster changes on June 30th, they'll be over a little bit. Right now, they've got fewer than 85 because obviously all the freshmen aren't here yet. But for the most part, most schools are under the 85. That is why you see over and over again that magical moment where the walk-on gets the scholarship, because they have room for it. Nick Ury, they have room for it. He gets a scholarship. Hunter Kelly, they had room for him. He moved up and got a scholarship. And this happens over and over and over again. That walk-on, that gets, because the scholarship is available. It means they're under 85. So what's to say that on April 30th that a player's not picked by April 30th, not picked, or doesn't like the draft position? I was picked in the fifth round. I think if I go back, I can make myself a second-round pick. Open the door and let him come back. This then accomplishes a couple of things along the way. Number one, it benefits the student-athlete. Number two, by letting them stay in school, you open the door to more academic progress toward a degree. Let's not forget that part. You have to go, you got to take classes. Well, that means you take another step academically toward getting your degree. And I think those are important factors. And it benefits the student athlete. And there should be room based on how I see things play out all the time across the board. Rarely are you in the Spike Albrecht predicament. Spike was the basketball player that scored 17 against Louisville in the first half of the national championship game for Michigan a couple of years back. And he had had hip problems and so forth, but he finally starts the season. He's healthy, plays the first 8 games of his senior season, and he hurts the hip again. Well, the problem is he had to leave Michigan at the end of the year. He couldn't stay on because Michigan, he was playing. So essentially, they recruited the max in the recruiting class, so he ended up transferring to Purdue. So that happens sometimes. But for the most part, there is room at the inn. So what would the NFL and the NBA say about this? Well, number one, Now, the rules have changed. Okay, understand, the rules have changed since this happened. But let's think of a famous player that was drafted and played his entire senior season as a drafted player. Who would that be? And what really shocked me, it really shocked me that nobody brought this up on Saturday. Jay, Seth, LaFonso, Reese never brought this up. Larry Bird played his last season at Indiana State as a drafted player. The Celtics drafted Larry Bird sixth overall in the 1978 draft. He didn't sign with the Celtics. He played his entire senior season with Indiana State. National Player of the Year, led them to the national championship game, but they were beaten by Magic and Michigan State. And then, before the draft, signed a deal with the Celtics. The NFL and NBA teams would retain the rights of that player right up until the start of the next draft. Then the player can go back into the next draft. But they would retain the negotiating rights with that player for a full year, right up until the commissioner says, and whatever your draft is now underway. They'd retain those rights. Now, those rules are not in place, but you would force the NFL and the NBA to put that rule in. You force the NBA to put it back in. So where's the tricky part in this? The tricky part in this is the agent part. In the NBA right now, you can retain an agent, the NCAA lets you, to help set up workouts and so forth. The NFL doesn't have that same agreement with the NCAA. They would need to. But I think you've got to be able to open the door to give student athletes more empowerment about testing the waters, and then suddenly look around saying, okay, now what are my options? The XFL, the G League? What are my options? I thought this was going to work out better for me. And I think they should have the option of going back. And this, I thought this was a very thoughtful discussion they had the other day. Very thoughtful. But they handled it really, really well. I would just like to have, you know, take it a little bit further. I think you already have a past model in place where one of the more famous players in the history of the NBA actually was drafted. He didn't put his name in, but I believe because he was a fourth-year player at that point. Because remember, Larry Bird started his career at Indiana and then transferred to Indiana State. So he was at that fourth year, and I think the NBA allowed you to do it, so Red Auerbach took him. Sixth. And he played his entire senior season as a Boston Celtics draft pick. And by the way, Larry Bird did get his degree in physical education. So he did get his degree, just so you know. I think it's just something to think about. We're seeing a lot of young people make mistakes. And when you have great talent, you have great confidence, and you think that you can do something. You also have a lot of people around you saying, Macatrillo, yeah, you're great. Go pro. Go pro. No, really go pro. In fact, just last week, you and I were telling the suit to go pro. But, I mean, we had ulterior motives. We'll come back with more in a moment on News Radio 1070 WKOK. For nearly 100 years, Purdy Insurance has been your locally owned, family-operated source for insurance products. With a staff of over 20 and partnerships with some of the industry's most trusted companies, Purdy has the experience and resources to get the job done. Whether you need personal, home, and auto, or complex business insurance solutions, Purdy will help you navigate through the process. Call today at 570-286-5855, or better yet, stop in their Sunbury office to see what Purdy Insurance can do for you. All right, great to have you with us today. Brought to you by our good friends at Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. We are in the Sunbury Motors studio. Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. Tomorrow's show from Lafayette, Indiana, as 13th-ranked Penn State gets ready to take on Purdue in what should be a heck of a showdown. Final half hour coming up here on News Radio 1070 WKOK.
Taking your calls at 800-795-9565. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now from the Sunbury Motors Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. And today's show brought to you by our good friends at Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. Purdy's have served the Valley for decades with their ability to find the best insurance, auto, home, life, business, bundles, wherever it may be. And they'll find you the best price. And they'll update the policy. And if there's ever a claim, they'll go to work as if it happened to them. Just great people or great professionals. Purdy Insurance, Market Street in Sunbury. Go to purdyinsurance.com. Shikellamy and Southern Columbia tonight in high school basketball. The Chief will be on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Matt will be on TV tonight.
Yep, SEC V8.
Who's the Chief working with tonight?
I think his first name starts with Kevin.
My brother's doing the game.
Yeah, wow. He's pitching in tonight.
I may want to listen to that. Yeah. Yes, Kevin Hurl will be there tonight. All right. So the XFL, you didn't watch any of it, did you?
No, I did not. I need to really see it to get going. I'm a pretty staunch NFL guy, and I really don't see this working very long. It's got the big hype because, yes, it's got Fox, yes, it's got ESPN. It's the first weekend. You had some names in there that are notable, but I need to wait a little bit more before I really start buying into this.
I thought it was actually pretty good. Didn't, you know, not great, awesome, or incredible. I mean, you know, but I thought it was pretty good. Thought there was some action in some games. Quarterback play. Matt was very good, by the way. Matt played very well. They had some big plays. They had some fun plays. Overall, not bad. Look, they've got the financial backing. I mean, that part's there. They've got the TV contracts. That part's there. You know, fan base. I will say this. You know what was interesting? There were several elements, by the way, that were interesting. One was they took you inside the replay booth. And you got to hear the conversation between the official on the field and the official in the replay booth. And I thought it was fascinating to listen to as to the process. And not only that, it was interesting to listen to the process. The problem you have in an NFL game is that when they go to the replay, you're left there watching replays. Well, by taking you inside the replay booth and you hear the discussion, it's interesting enough where it kept your interest and you weren't really thinking about the game being delayed. And the replay official in the New York-Tampa Bay game, it was a play where it was a fumble recovered by New York and brought back to the half-yard line. So they had to see first if there was a completion. If there was a completion, then it's obviously a fumble because there was no knee down or anything like that. And then the last part was whether he got in. And the first thing the official says, the replay booth, on the catch part was, oh boy, this is going to be close. Well, fine, that's good. It tells you right away how tough it is. It also tells you that they are on track to being at minimum stands as called. Now, that I liked. Now, that taking us inside the replay booth was great. You know, the interviews during the games, the coach, the players. Okay, that's fine. They have more access. That's fine. You know, hearing the coaches call plays, that's fine. Yeah, whatever. There are any, you know, through one weekend, you're not going to have any stars. It wasn't like they had a chance to go out and draft anybody that is a star. Because they're not there trying to compete with the NFL. But I thought, for the most part, it wasn't that bad. I thought the hitting was pretty good. You know, not every game's a masterpiece. That's what we try to tell the suit after every broadcast. They're not all a masterpiece. I'm surprised he's even talking to you with you stealing his audience tonight. I'm concerned.
We'll have to compare ratings.
Oh, it's already in the bag. I mean, the only thing that's saving the radio sets is the Chief.
By the way, we did have our first firing in the XFL after day one. The LA Wildcats already parted ways with their DC Pepper Johnson.
Really?
I'd like to be him right now.
Wow. That didn't take long at all. Boy, one game, they're already dissatisfied.
Pretty sad for that guy.
Yeah, that's not good at all. Huh. Well, I didn't see the games, because I can't tell you if he did a bad job or not. You'd be shocked how the personnel figure.
Well, I was actually flipping through the channels yesterday while I was going through some college hoops and all that, and I noticed it was they were getting crushed by whoever they were playing. I forgot who it was.
Oh no, really?
Yeah, they gave up 37-20 something, I think, at one point. I don't know what the final was.
Let's see. Headlines here. Do you know what the XFL should do? They should sign Carly Lloyd as a kicker. Why not?
Now, that would be intriguing. I'll give you that.
Hey, what the heck? It would be interesting, don't you think?
It would be, although she's a little busy at the moment because you have the World Cup, you have the Olympics qualifying.
Look, I don't want to hear about her problems, okay? just get out of the football field and put a helmet on. Let's go play. I think it would be interesting. But for week one, look, I think for week one, let's put it this way. They are way ahead of where the Alliance of American Football was a year ago in terms of quality of play, my opinion. And I watched a little bit of the Alliance. Now, they have the built-in advantage of the TV contracts between Fox and ESPN. That's a pretty good start in terms of the ability to get people interested.
And that's with some decent names, too, because the one Fox game, I think it was the New York game, Steve, Kurt Menefee was the play-by-play with Joel Klatt. That was the broadcast team for one of them, I think it was. It might have been the New York game.
Yeah, it was the D.C. game.
Oh, D.C. game, that's right, yeah.
D.C. game. I think Kevin Burkhart and Greg Olson did the game between New York and Tampa Bay yesterday.
Well, there you go. Oh. By the way, the L.A. score was 37-17. They lost to the Houston Roughnecks.
Really?
We got to work on some of these names.
Okay, so Penn State sports right now. This is how things go. Right now, men's lacrosse is ranked number one in the country. Okay. Women's volleyball finished eighth. Women's soccer finished 18th. Men's soccer finished 13th. Wrestling is currently number two. Men's ice hockey is currently number nine. Football finished at number nine. Men's basketball is ranked 13th. Wow. You now add that in with women's cross country was 18. Men's fencing finished number four, is now number four. Men's fencing is number four. Women's fencing is number six. Men's gymnastics is number six. Women's gymnastics is ranked number 23. Women's indoor track is ranked 14th. It's pretty good. Pretty good little run. It's a fun place to be. Fun place to be. And if you missed it, Adam Rittenberg is reporting that the long list of people who have turned down the Michigan State job, and again, I was standing right there when Mark D'Antonio got emotional. So, oh, that's a job anybody would jump at. Really? Well, evidently, not everybody is, quote, jumping at it. Adam Rittenberg's reporting that Brent Pry is the latest to say no to Michigan State. And it is a list of people who have said no. Brent Pry has said no. He's going to stay as the defensive coordinator here. Luke Fickell of Cincinnati has said no. Matt Campbell of Iowa State has said no. Pat Narduzzi took his name out of the running to begin with. Mel Tucker of Colorado has said no. I mean, that's five people who have said no. They're not all jumping at the job the way Mark D'Antonio said they would. New name that's emerged is Brett Bielema, the outside linebacking coach of the Giants. Former Wisconsin and Arkansas coach. So we'll get you up to date on that. We'll come back with more in a moment here on News Radio 1070 WKOK, brought to you by Purdy Insurance. When it comes to car buying, there's the other guy's way, and then there's the SMC way. The other guys force you into a vehicle you really don't want. The Sunbury Motors way lets you take the time you need to browse, ask questions, and take the test drive and think on it. For over 100 years, the Mertz family and all their employees have made your experience the most pleasant one you'll ever have. The other guys won't offer you the best price for your trade, no matter how much they say they will. The SMC way is their promise to provide you with the most money the market shows your vehicle is worth. The SMC way is to offer you all applicable factory rebates on new vehicles and generous discounts. Looking for a pre-owned vehicle? The SMC way checks each vehicle in a 200-mile radius to determine the lowest price, then beat it. It's the lowest price promise, just part of the SMC way. The choice is up to you. The other guy's way or the SMC way? The SMC way wins every time. Sunbury Motors Company in the North 4th Street Auto Plaza, Sunbury, and at sunburymotors.com. Selling more cars and satisfying more customers for over 100 years. Tonight in the Battle of the Broadcasts, we are anxiously awaiting the ratings between SET TV and News Radio 1070 WKOK. Matt Cotrillo will be on TV tonight. Meanwhile, Kevin Herr and the Chief, Dave Ritchie, will be on the radio tonight. Maybe you'll sync up the radio to TV.
There you go.
Or maybe the lure of the Chief, as great as it is to listen to him, will be offset by the other guy, and now you're like, okay, maybe I'll watch TV. No? And we'll see. I mean, this could be a ratings bonanza. I mean, for example, Nesson's ratings of the Red Sox last year were down a bit. We may find that your ratings are way up.
We'll see.
Huh?
It's on.
You know, what really would have been cool is that if you stole the Chief away, and now, like, the two of you are on together. No?
I would love to do a game with... Actually, have I done a game with the Chief? I've done one game with him.
I believe you had, because he said it was the greatest broadcast experience he personally ever had.
But I would love, regardless, I'd love to do another one or two with him. Football or basketball?
I'm just saying. I said, what made you say that? He goes, what do you think? Oh, God. TV audience for the Super Bowl. Television-only audience, 99.9 million, up 1% from last year's game on CBS. Actually up to 102.1 million when you add in Fox Deportes and Digital Fox. 102.1 million. First time the TV audience has increased for the Super Bowl since 2015. The pregame show was the most watched pregame show since 2016. The halftime show actually drew 104.1 million. Let's see. Most live-streamed Super Bowl in history, which you expect more people are streaming now than ever. Delivering an average minute audience of 3.4 million. This year marked the ninth consecutive year that the Super Bowl halftime show drew a larger audience than the game itself. 148.5 million Americans watched all or part of the Super Bowl, while 138.8 million people voted in the 2016 election. New Orleans had the highest rating for the Super Bowl, 54.1. Excuse me, New Orleans posted a rating of 54.1. Only Kansas City was higher. New Orleans' rating, by the way, was up 107% over last year when some Saints fans boycotted the Super Bowl. The first 15 minutes of the Super Bowl pregame show had 6.7 million viewers. The final minutes had 84.3 million. The audience at kickoff was 84.3 million, up 3% from last year. That's how they break it down. January 31st, wrestling meet between Iowa and Penn State became the most watched wrestling telecast in BTN history. The meet had 342,955 viewers. Strong ratings for softball. The Women's College World Series, two-game championship series, UCLA-Oklahoma, drew an average of 1,574,000 viewers last year. How about that? Not bad. Just some numbers to throw out there for you. So, Matt, the opening 15 minutes of the Super Bowl pregame show had 6.7 million viewers, including you and Luke.
That is correct.
Right, final minutes, 84.3 million, which still didn't include me.
And, of course, you weren't included in the halftime show either, those ratings.
No. Kevin was shocked when he heard I didn't even watch the halftime show. I'm like, I don't want it. I don't really care. Like, I want to get something to eat.
Yeah, my tradition is always dessert time at halftime.
Really? And what was for dessert this year?
Lisa made football-shaped brownies that were outstanding.
She kind of, like, does it all.
She does. She really does.
Today's show has been brought to you by Purdy Insurance. Market Street in summer. Go to purdyinsurance.com.